guys. I was originally going to do a presentation on Bubba Watson because he's such a hot ticket. But the more I looked at what he had and what the data I had and the work video I had, I realized I wasn't going to do him justice. So I thought I'd show you a quick presentation of Blob Man. Now, Blob Man is a work that was initially started in the early 1990s from the work we did at the biomechanics lab and at the University of Reno, at University of Nevada at Reno. And so let me just show you what this is. It's a we did a data capture of Mr. Hogan's golf swing, and we sent that data capture information to Silicon Graphics in Silicon Valley, and they got back to us with a three-dimensional model, and this is a representation of that model. Now, what this what we have here is we have three different views. We have the front view, the top view, and the right view. And what's interesting is that I always think that traces are, anybody that's seen my work in the past here understands that I think traces are important, because it's something that that we have from start to finish. People get I used to use video all day every day, and now I use it a lot less because people got stuck in positions trying to get to a release point, an impact position, a follow through, and anytime they got stuck in a picture, they would jeopardize or certainly interfere with a good motion. And I think the motion is the most important. And so let's take a look at a right shoulder trace, for example. Now, we have a reference line here to show you how he moves away from the right side. And this is a right shoulder trace. And let's just run it here. That's maybe a little fast. Let's slow him down. Okay. Now, see, from this view, you can see the verticality of how far down he goes from the top of his shoulder travel to impact, or just past impact to follow through. Now, the nice thing about the data, we had 240 frames. This is taken from film of Hogan when he did the tip after Shell's Wonderful World of Golf. And the nice thing about that footage is it's 90 frames a second, so which is really interesting for 1964, because there just wasn't 90 frames a second. So that makes the data a little more useful than it does at 30 frames a second. Now let's take a look at the other view from the right shoulder. And we'll go to the right shoulder. Now then, when we see this view, we will then see how far out he goes. See, now the right shoulder is, you know, I think obviously the poor player right shoulder comes around to the left, and while he really turns, his right shoulder goes out to the right for the longest time, and at the tip end, it comes back to the left. Now let's take a look at that from the right view. Right shoulder. Now we see how far in he goes, how far down he goes, and it's an interesting look. And again, you can see how far out he goes. Through the ball, he goes out, away from the plane. Now, the other thing that's really neat about Blob Man, one of my favorite things, is we can hide and show parts, body parts. So let's go and take a look at how little up he has in a golf swing. And if you just run his trace here, or if you run the simulation, That looks like a normal size Gosling. Let's take a look. What happens if we get rid of the club? We get rid of his left forearm, his left upper arm, his, well, let's get rid of both his right forearm. We'll just look at the pivot. It doesn't look like a lot of up there. Now let's add his right upper arm. And then take a look at his right elbow trace. Now let's run this. Now one of the things you'll see, let's run that a couple more times. One of the things you'll see here is how little up there is in his upper right arm. And obviously our students are lifting their upper right arm. Now I like to think of the golf swing as having no backswing, no upswing, but only has a backswing. Now at the end it certainly goes up, doesn't it? All right, so now we'll add his right forearm. And we'll take a look at a hand trace, maybe. Do I have one? Yes, it is. There's one. Now let's look at that. Okay, that looks a lot more up. And what you can see, let's get rid of those traces. What you can see is how it lifts up. It falls up. I like to say it falls up. See, the forearm falls up. And then if you add the club to this, now it looks like a big golf swing again. All right, so that's fun. Let's take a look at the right side view and how left he gets. All right, so now we'll get rid of the reference line and we'll get rid of the right forearm, right upper arm, club shaft. Now let's get those back. Let's just run this once. And see, when we run it normally, I think our eyes are often our eyes, although the good instructors and the experienced instructors who keep watching these golf swings that we see all the time, we don't get necessarily trapped by seeing the fastest moving part, but that's kind of what happens the most, is we see the fastest moving parts. When you see a shape, you see what the club is doing. Now, since we can get rid of parts, let's get rid of the club. Let's get rid of his right forearm and his right upper arm. Now we'll just take a look at the leftness of this. Well, that's interesting. Now let's get rid of the left forearm. Now we'll put the reference line there. Then we'll take a look at the left elbow. And let's see what we see. Now let's get rid of the tracer we'll keep. We'll get rid of the reference line. Left elbow. And the trace. Now watch. Now it looks dramatically left. Now we'll just add his left upper arm. Excuse me, left forearm. And then we'll look at, we don't have a hand trace, do we? Well, we'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of the traces and we'll run it again. And again, when that left forearm goes up, you don't see how left it is again. You lose that. Let's get rid of the left forearm again. Let's keep the trace again and left forearm. All right, that's pretty sweet. So that gives somebody a sense of how far left we should get. And at the same time, let's put it all back. And let's make a run here. Then we look at the right shoulder again. And as far left as the forearm goes, you get to see how far right the right shoulder goes. So that's an interesting element, right? So the right shoulder's going out to the right and the left arm's going to the left. And if the left forearm elbow went to the right, we'd be in trouble. And if the right shoulder went to the left, we'd be in trouble. So anyway, there's a quick overview of what Bloodman can do. And all the parts are hideable and showable. We get to see from all views. Let's take a look at the right hip. Right hip. That's the left hip. Right hip. Get rid of that guy. Let's run this. Well, I found this guy. When I found the right hip, I thought that the right hip just turned to the left. I thought it was a hip turn. And you can see how far he moves away from his line. You see how far in he gets away from the line to start with. And while he's swinging the hip to the left, on his right hip, it's still on his right foot. So, and then you see how far out to the right he goes. And then when we looked at everybody, I thought this was a secret for sure. And then I looked at, that's what I did. That's what Fowler does. That's what Nicholas does. That's what pretty much everybody did when we looked at him. Freddie Couples had a check mark. He went straight back and through. So he didn't have the circularity. But, so, that is what you can see with Blob Man. And it's fascinating because you can look at him for hours and watch things. And I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope your day is good. We're learning more and more about the golf swing. This is a fun time to be a golf instructor. Enjoy your day. Thank you very much.